this place. Dante's Inferno, the devil's maze. It's a good world.
Here from Knox. We've been riding this, the Benelli Leoncino, for the last couple of days in the Lake District. We're actually at Surprise View, which is just one of the most epically beautiful places in the Lake District, which is about 10 miles away from the Knox HQ and where we're making a huge amount of the range. So we've taken the time out to test this bike, see what we think, also testing the gear at the same time. And a really interesting bike actually, Mark, isn't it?
It is a truly revelatory motorcycle, this. I'm so surprised by how impressed I've been by this.
Yeah.
I think one of the reasons why we decided we wanted to road test this bike and put it through its paces, because at this price point, there aren't many big bikes to choose from. There just isn't an awful lot of options available for you. So I'm just staggered, to be honest, by what you get at just over £5,000, parallel twin. It's A2 license compliant, so it makes 35 kilowatts, which is about 47 horsepower. You know, it's a full size, real adult motorcycle, isn't it?
Well, it is. And you know, one of the things when we first talked about like road testing a Benelli, it's like, Benelli, my god, they've been bust more times than probably Buell or something. They're a bit of a mixed bag, you know. The bike I remember from the Benelli range is obviously the Tornado, which was super popular, super sports bike. And then obviously I saw the Leoncino and I thought, wow, that's a really interesting bike.
Absolutely.
And do you know what? It's been an absolute pleasure to ride, hasn't it? I've been, like you, really surprised of how this thing rides.
I really didn't exactly know what to expect when we picked this bike up.
Could have been a bag of spanners, to be honest.
It really could have. And look, you know, I think you've got to accept that in certain respects it can be and is a little bit agricultural. You know, the individual parts on this aren't hugely expensive. It's not draped in Olins and Brembos. It's kind of... it's built to a price.
Well, and it's got his massive made in China sticker
they're not sure about
engine.
That. I mean, you know,
exactly.
It's got Benelli on the badge, but it is made by a Chinese company. It's a Chinese motor. It's manufactured in China. And I can't even pronounce the name of the company that own it and make it. But yes, absolutely. Top to bottom, that's what it is. But it still has a kind of certain Italian charm about it, doesn't it?
It does. It's
one of those motorcycles you kind of get on it instantly. You can feel like you can chuck it around instantly. Yeah. You feel comfortable with it. It's got a great riding position. Pegs aren't too high, so you can get comfortable. You can sit on it. I mean, we've done, hours and hours of riding on this bike over the last couple of days.
Oh, yeah.
Not once did I think, oh, you know, my bum's starting to get sore. Not once did I think, oh, my legs are stiff. You know, it's just super comfortable, super easy to ride. Motor makes sensible power. It pulls through the rev range. Yeah, it's got limitations. And I think, you know, if I was really nitpicking, I might say the suspension's slightly on the stiffer side. But actually, when you're on the move and on the run, it's perfectly usable, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. It's really a bike that you can chuck around all over the place, I think. I think it's dead nimble. I think it's got a nice amount of power. I mean, you know, if you're new into biking, if you've done that A2 license,
yeah,
which this would be compliant for at 48 horsepower.
47
horsepower. So it's A2 license compliant. It's a twin, but actually the way that it delivers the power is just really nice.
It's linear, isn't it?
It's dead totally linear. Flat. It's not lumpy at all. And you know, it just makes you think that you can rag it around everywhere, which, to be fair, we have, you know. And
we probably shouldn't go into too much detail about that.
No,
but exactly where this bike's been over the last 2 days.
And you know, you could ride it anywhere. So this is actually the trail version, which is slightly raised in its height. We didn't realise we were going to get this one, but actually it's been a real pleasure. It's slightly higher up. It's got Metzler Endurance tyres on, which is just a little bit more knobbly and means you can just take it off-road a little bit, which we have actually. And you know, it's been a really good bike just to go on. I mean, you know, you're not going to be doing heavy, you know, off-roading work on this, but no. The odd trail here and there handles it absolutely. Well,
it's not a heavy bike either. I think it's around fully fueled. It's around 200 kilos. I mean, it's not a light bike, but it's certainly not a heavy bike by any means. I mean, you know,
no, sure.
It's this kind of semi-knobbly tire, isn't it?
Semi-knobbly.
We probably ought to ask Jeff to come in now and tell us about his own off-road experiences with this bike, but I think it held its own in that environment, and it does exactly the same on the road. I think.
And it's so confidence inspiring as well that you really feel that you can flick it around on the road, and of course that translates to a bit of off-road stuff
certainly
too.
Certainly does.
It's also got all the protection over all of the downpipes. The exhaust got some protection on it. It's got a bit of off-road.
I mean, there are some nice touches, LED indicators, LED headlight, the information you get on the clocks is good. It's got a gear selection indicator, it's got a fuel gauge, which works. It's got a rev counter. So, you know, it kind of ticks a huge number of boxes. It's, again, in this kind of, in the idea of having a sort of your first big bike, it does feel like a big bike. It rides like a big bike, but it still has a huge appeal, a broad appeal.
Yeah.
But I think for me, the most important factor with this bike, the most impressive part about it is how much you get for your money. You know, at just over £5,000, what can you buy brand new with a warranty? First brand new bike at this level. And that's where this bike comes into its own. Yes, you can say the individual pieces on the bike aren't the top of the range, but it's the kind of sum of the parts, isn't it?
Sure.
And when you put it all together, you know, it's a really compelling package.
Absolutely.
I'm really, really pleasantly surprised.
And you might be able to pick up something in a similar-ish price bracket to that from some of the big four manufacturers. However, whether they quite have the same charm as this?
Well, absolutely.
I would question.
I think it's got a real lovability, this bike, hasn't it?
Dead charming bike. I mean, we had a guy who turned up a couple of days ago at the Knox HQ, and he'd brought this 883 Sports custom bike. And I said, "Hey, well, I'll have a little look at this." And do you know what? He was like, "Ooh, I really like that."
Yeah.
I was quite amazed. Really. Well, I mean, I love the little lion on the front.
The lion cub. I mean, you know, we haven't really talked about the styling particularly, have we? And I've got to say, you know, it is a very good looking motorcycle. At the price point, you get a stylish bike, you get a rideable bike, you get a comfortable bike, you get a usable bike. You know, and that appeal is, as I say, is pretty broad. You know, a commuter, somebody coming into riding their first big bike, an A2 license compliant rider. You know, there is a huge appeal for it, isn't there? And I think, you know, the whole point of this is that when we came to think about what we're going to road test next, we wanted to look at something alternative.
Yes.
You know, we could have gone down the route of just picking the obvious choices, a Triumph or a Ducati, or one of the major manufacturers, but we thought actually we fancy looking at something alternative, and this is what we found. And again, the value for money aspect of this is what really seals it. Just touching on the value for money, we did have a quick look at, as we generally do, in terms of what it would cost you on a month-to-month basis. Millenium Motorcycles, thank you very much, Millenium, Dan at St. Helens, who kindly loaned us this bike. They've got a finance package available on this particular motorcycle. Specific retail price at £5,199. If you put £199 deposit down, it will cost you £123 a month, I think, over 4 years. We'll put a link in the video so we can reconfirm the actual figures. But, you know, £200 deposit, just over 100 quid a month, brand new motorcycle. You know, I've got to say, it does strike me as tremendous value for money, this bike.
Absolutely, it does. So obviously a big part of us testing these bikes and, you know, just being riders is not only from the point of view of testing the bikes, but also testing the gear that we're producing and making and selling. And that's been a big part of what we're also doing out here. Now, we are actually putting together a separate video for all the gear that we have been specifically wearing. We will put all the links in the description, but please check out that separate video. I'll put a link in there as well for that. So overall then, Mark, what's your summary of this? Do you like it or not?
I think there are a couple of sort of standout aspects of this bike. The first has got to be the value for money. The price point is fantastic. And I think secondly, and just as importantly, is how well the bike rides. Again, at the price point, how much more bike can you get brand new at £5,000 than one of these? You get an authentic Italian, you know, long-standing, charismatic motorcycle at £5,000. I think for me, you know, that's the thing that kind of seals it. I've been unbelievably impressed with this bike, actually. It's really, we have tested other bikes around it, and I've got to say, this is the one I'd want to, once we've finished doing this video and we've done our photos, this would be the one I want to grab the keys for, jump on and ride out of here.
And my opinion also is that it's just been a really, really good fun bike to ride, and I view it very much on that basis. It's great to chuck around, it's great to jump on and just ride, dead simple motorbike to ride. I love actually the fact as well that the exhaust sounds pretty good.
It does, it's pretty fruity, right?
Yeah, most new motorbikes that are brand new sound totally rubbish.
Well, your focus is, like, strangles bikes, doesn't it? It strangles what that...
Well, these guys have sort of managed to get away with it. And, you know, it sounds a bit fruity, it pops on the overrun.
It does.
Love it, it's got loads of character.
Yeah, 100%.
So, you know, we're a real fan of it. So thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed that one. Please subscribe to the channel if you're not already. Please like, please comment. We'd love to hear what you think and what actually you think we should review next. We'd be really interested to hear what you've got to say. We will see you next time. A sad state of affairs. Half the people die while the rest of us are splitting hairs. It's a good world. Good world gone.